So what is this MVC all about? Well, MVC stands for Model View Controller, and it's one of architectural patterns for implementing user interfaces. Although it was originally developed for desktop applications back in the 1970s, it's been widely adopted as an architecture for web applications. And as a result, many frameworks have been created that enforce this pattern. ASP.NET MVC is one of them. There are many other similar MVC frameworks like Ruby on Rails or Express for Node. In an MVC application, model represents the application data and behavior in terms of its problem domain and independent of the user interface. For example, in our video rental application, our model will consist of classes like movie, customer, rental, transaction, and so on. These classes have properties and methods that purely represent the application state and rules. They are not tied to the user interface, which means you can take these classes and use them in a different kind of app like a desktop or a mobile app. They are plain old CLR objects or POCOs. V in MVC represents the view, and it's the HTML markup that we display to the user. And C is a controller, which is responsible for handling an HTTP request. For example, imagine our application is hosted at vidly.com. When we send a request to vidly.com/movies, a controller will be selected to handle this request. This controller will get all the movies from the database, put them in a view, and return the view to the client or the browser. So with this architecture, you see each component has a distinct responsibility, and this results in better separation of concerns and a more maintainable application. Now, there is one more piece to this architecture, which is not in the acronym MVC, but is nearly always there. It's a router. Earlier, I told you that when a request comes in the application, a controller will be selected for handling that request. Selecting the right controller is the responsibility of a router. A router, based on some rules, knows that the request with the URL/movies should be handled by a class called MoviesController. More accurately, it should be handled by one of the methods of this class, because a class can have many different methods. In ASP.NET MVC, we refer to methods of a controller as actions. So it's more accurate to say that an action in a controller is responsible for handling a request. So this was ASP.NET MVC in 3 minutes.